Okay, I may just be a little bit obsessed with Star Trek again. Always have been since I was a little kid, but having rewatched the new movies, I really fancied playing this game again. I've not actually got past the first mission, I just tested it out and then never got back to it. So this seems like a good opportunity to test it out. This is Star Trek. Let's go. So this game's had a fairly mixed set of reviews from what I saw. I really like the aesthetics of it. They've got the new movies down quite well. The models are pretty accurate. And it just feels Star Trek. I am, of course, going to go with Kirk. Because, why not? I'm going to play this with the controller as well, since it is a console game. So, hey. Brash, bold, and clever. Yep, that's what I'm gonna do. Right, public, private, right, offline. Don't random people jumping in and ruining my game experience!
Ambush! Their numbers are overwhelming. Surrender may be our only option.
No! Don't give them an inch!
Okay, so straight in with action. Left trigger to aim, right trigger to fire, seems fairly standard. Oh, okay. I wondered what I was shooting at for over there. I'm really rubbish at any kind of shooter. Which is funny. Yo! Was that a grenade being thrown at me? Or me throwing a grenade? Spot, be more specific! Well, that was quite a dramatic start. I have no memory of this. This is good. So it's kind of like all of the movies. They start off with something. It's got nothing to do with the main plot. But just to see if you can get straight in with the action and see how characters interact. Works well for a game tutorial. You're gonna punch Spock? Wait, what? Right, okay. So that's how he envisaged a game.
Move,
chess.
Captain. I'm aware of that, Mr. Spock.
No, alright. 8 hours earlier.
Damn it!
Your choice was valid, Captain, but highly predictable.
Predictable? Since when have I ever been predictable?
That is precisely why the move was predictable, Captain.
Captain, we have received an emergency signal from a nearby space station. Please report to the bridge at once.
Shall we finish the game later, or do you concede defeat?
Never.
You should know me better than that by now, Spock. I never concede.
Just get a little sneak in there. So very Kirk. Okay, use the left thingy to direct movement and the right to control the camera. I want to see if I can also set subtitles, because I prefer being able to read things just in case I miss it. No, don't restart the level. That's silly. Options, subtitles on. Yep, we're good. Okay, so we've got an action game with good set story in the Star Trek universe with amazing music and the proper voice actors, which is also really helping with the immersion.
Oh, talk around the phase oscillation?
That's the first thing I tried.
I'm stumped.
Captain.
Chief.
Ooh, I just got the results of those scans. Good work, Ensign.
It's a tricorder things as well. Hello. Can I do anything with the tricorder? Push the other button, no? Hang on, hold. why Spock moved to. Alright, so I can tell Spock to go over there.
Clock's ticking, Commander.
Commander?
Chief?
Nice. I just got the results of those scans. Good work, Ensign.
Yeah, you talk to them, Spock. Hi. Jim Kirk, I'm your captain. Let me scan you for your measurement screen, lady. Oh, okay, I have to reach the bridge. The bridge is, looks like it's over there, but I just want to look around. I am unfortunately really easy to distract him. You're blocking my way, I'm the captain! Get out of the way! No? Alright, okay. Onto the bridge. I don't think there's a lot
What's
to distract
going on
you.
Down there?
The radiation from those binary stars is making communications difficult, but the station appears to be in some sort of distress.
Hmm. Check off readings.
They're operating on emergency power and are struggling to maintain altitude.
Cause?
Unknown, sir.
Captain, they have issued a request for immediate evacuation.
Then let's help them out. Mr. Scott, prepare transporters.
I wouldn't recommend it, sir. Those stars are giving off too much interference. Unless we achieve manual lock, we might fry those little guys.
Then we'll get them out the old-fashioned way. Prepare my shuttle, meet me in the bay.
Aye, aye, sir.
Captain, in spite of your seemingly endless desire to stretch your legs, I must remind you that you are still a Starfleet captain. This is clearly a job that Mr. Scott and a few ensigns could handle.
But then I'd miss all the fun.
Sir, the more prudent choice would be to stay on the Enterprise and wait for a response to our hails.
Oh, you're right. Lieutenant Uhura, any response to our hails?
None, sir.
No, looks like I'm going.
Use the turbo lift. I say, yeah, there's a lot of things to get distracted by, apart from how pretty this game is. I mean, considering half the stuff in Star Trek is computer generated, it does mean that a game can look like really nice, but seriously, that's a lot of detail for a movie-based game. You can see the ship, the writing on it, on 701, and everything out the window, glowy flashy lights. There's no lens flare though. J.J. Abrams must be quite disappointed. But hello, Uhura.
Uhura, any luck reaching that station?
No, sir. They aren't responding to any of our hails, but the ship is surrounded by intense radiation. It may be interfering with their communications.
See, I tried. But, Anton.
Hello, Captain.
Tell me about those energy fluctuations.
Inconclusive, sir. I will have to recalibrate the sensors.
Let me know as soon as you have more information.
Please do throw in some more Star Trek technobubble. Hey, Sulu.
Captain?
Sulu, get suited up. You're taking us over there.
Yes, sir. I'll meet you in shuttle bay.
Something's not right here. I'm picking up strange energy fluctuations beyond those stars.
Are you detecting any weapons on that station?
Negative, sir. They're clean.
At least we know that much.
Can I keep talking to him?
Still trying to figure out those fluctuations. I have nothing new to report.
Okay, so I could really annoy him if I kept talking to him. move on. Wrong turbo lift. Wrong turbo lift. It should be on the one next to her. No, not this one. Oh, I got lost already. Ah, see, tricorder. Red dot shows you where you're going. I'm sure I was in the right place. Hello? Ah, here we go. Come on, Spock!
Captain, I must insist.
You insist? You know what, Mr. Spock? A change of scenery might do you some good.
Captain,
you come with me.
Your shuttle's ready, Captain. But do you think it's wise to go yourself? I'm sure me and some recruits could handle this.
Don't worry, Scotty. We'll be fine.
Always makes me nervous when he says that.
I'm taking away the fun from Mr. Scott.
Mr. Scott, is there no way to transport survivors off that vessel?
I like to think that nothing is impossible, Commander. But with that much interference out there, I wouldn't recommend it. Stupid place to park a space station, if you ask me.
Simon Pegg sense of humor. Love it. Hello, security red shirt. You're going to die. Probably. More under people stood around, blocking my way.
Spock, get suited up.
Yeah. Rapid change of clothing. Kind of being funneled in a one-way system. But this is an action game. It's
Enterprise
designed.
Enterprise shuttle confirming approach at 5x6.
Get you in there.
Minimal safe distance.
Affirmative, Enterprise.
We're picking up high levels of radiation from two binary stars.
A normal space station would have been fried by those two stars by now. What the hell are they doing out there?
Captain, the station appears to be outfitted with solar collectors, but they are unlike any I have ever encountered.
Mr. Sulu, do you have any clue what an experimental power station would be doing out here in the middle of nowhere?
Negative, Captain. Whatever they're doing, Starfleet doesn't have any record of it.
Preparing for final approach.
I'm just hoping there's no stealth
in
this.
I don't think we plan on staying on that thing for too long.
Aye, Captain.
I don't like stealth. So you have to take your time, patient, and none of that. So, I'll be very Kirk in all things. Run in. See what happens. Unlike Kirk, I get distracted by everything! What? Hello. Okay. I was not expecting that. This place seems to be falling apart!
Radiation scan commencing. Please step forward for decontamination.
Whoa! Okay, a flashback of the Resident Evil movie there. That was going to slice me up.
Officer, where is the captain of this station?
This way. You must hurry.
Oh, whoa. Okay, yeah, I thought you survived for a moment there. Oops.
Damn it. Is this the fun you were afraid you were going to miss, Captain?
Yes.
Right. We need to get everyone out of here right away. Captain, we must find an alternate route.
Very perceptive, Mr. Spock.
Okay, so press A to jump. So I can climb over things. The really awkward. Oh, it's better. But like a really awkward jump. Press and hold X for next to a vent to enter it. Ooh, vent. Okay. I love the way that games put tutorials in.
Captain, we're picking up some strange readings. There appears to be some sort of anomaly.
Kinda have our hands full. Anything we need to worry about right now?
The readings are off the charts, sir, but I don't think so.
And just keep an eye on it, Mr. Chekhov.
Aye, aye, sir.
Okay, being directed down there. I do miss having like physical instruction manuals, but you know, vaguely clever introductions to games help. As long as the game's intuitive.
Give me some of that Vulcan strength to get this door open.
Is that another dead person? Why are you not wearing red? You're dying quick enough. So we're a Vulcan. Hold your breath.
Let's get him out of there.
I believe the door can be hacked from this side.
Please, you must be.
Hold the tricorder. Oops, select something. Hold X to unlock it. Okay. Tricorder's highlighting the wires. Okay.
I am in your debt.
Formalities are unnecessary. Please proceed to the shuttle bay for immediate evacuation.
Come on, we just saved you. Don't die.
I must mention that many of these crew members appear to be Vulcan.
Your point.
With fewer than 10,000 Vulcans remaining, I question the logic of placing them on any type of experimental power station.
Yeah.
I question putting anybody on this thing, Mr. Spock, Vulcan or not.
The Vulcans are an endangered species. Come on. Alright. But I can hack everything. Match signals? What do I do? Really, what am I doing, Dane? Oh, am I supposed to go... Wait, I don't know what I'm doing! Oh, I do! I aborted! Don't... You know, punish me for aborting. Let's try again. Right, so I have to look at the signal at the bottom, I think. No, it's got a thin, wobbly, wavy line. I think. No. Okay! Right, so you have to match left and right. Oh, I'm so gonna No! A bot! I'm dying doing a mini game in the introduction level! I want to work this out though, now I know what I'm doing. Okay. So I come down and I got... Jiggy. Are they the same? No. Oh, I like that one. It's... No. I don't know how many of these signals am I supposed to match? I don't know! They're matched. Oh, up and down zigzaggy. I gotta give them names. Come on, 2 seconds! Yes! For XPs! 100 XPs! Mr. Spock! Totally had time to do that while the station breaks apart. Oh, that makes sense. Hello? Look, last time there was a bridge, it collapsed. Why would you walk across something like... Yeah, why would you walk across it? You already know they're going to blow up. Oh, that's awesome. I'm like Assassin's Creed in this.
Hey Spock, you look like you need a hand!
Sir, we need to disable that laser arm.
Otherwise, yeah. Can I hack it? No, I just disable it, that's cool.
Captain, the anomaly and the failure of this station are most assuredly connected.
One catastrophe at a time, Mr. Spock.
Okay, it's my turn to go and leap around in a very James T. Kirk style of fashion. I have no fear. Nothing to hack. Something I already disabled, I think. Can I? Stop turning around! I knew it. There's an evil laser grid thing.
That doesn't sound good.
Captain, I would not advise stepping into that scanner.
No other way around, Spock.
Is there no way to disable it? Okay. Crap. Nothing to scan. Okay. Oh, hello. You. It's a healing point! Yay, I can get the healing back from, you know, failing hacking. Because when you fail to hack something, you take damage. Right. Hello.
Captain Kirk of the USS Enterprise, we have a shuttle ready for your evacuation.
While we appreciate your assistance, our captain and many of our top scientists are trapped in the transporter room on the other side of the station. We cannot simply abandon them.
Any suggestions, Mr. Spock?
If we were able to reach them, Mr. Scott may then be able to obtain a manual lock on our positions.
I'm afraid that may prove impossible. All interior passages are blocked.
Will the suits hold up out there?
With the solar shield failing, direct exposure would mean certain death.
Well, I hate certain death. Spock, let's try to avoid direct exposure.
Captain, I will offer whatever assistance I can over your communicator, but again, I fear that these efforts...
Yeah, we get it. Certain death. Any other words of advice?
Try to live long and prosper.
Was that, like, a little snide remark from a Vulcan? I think the word certain death is like a trigger word for Kirk. You know, like, I have to do it now to prove my manliness. Oh, I hope we get some epic music at the end of this mission. Okay, so can't scan anything in here. Scan. Oh, it was the key thing. Hello? I want to go through the melting room, but apparently I cannot go through the melting room. Airlock then.
We should engage mag boots now, sir.
I'm assuming that's automatic.
The solar collector is failing. We must avoid direct exposure.
That suit is gonna melt off your back. Get into cover, Spock.
Okay. Cover mechanics?
We should stay in cover until it regenerates.
Got it. Wait for it.
There's a mission like this on Star Trek Online, which is
go now.
Quite cool.
Captain, we should stay in cover until it regenerates.
Yeah, I failed that miserably. Am I nearly dead again? That's so good. It wasn't letting me run! Okay, let's play a little bit more sensible this time. When you see this... Alright, so the shield goes from the outside in. I get that now. I get that. Run!
I am uncertain how much more exposure our suits can handle.
Not much. That's the way I'm going at it. Oh god! That would absolutely terrify me! Oh, sorry. Running! Running!
What was this anyway? I believe it was yours, sir. Right.
God. The power of a star blasting you at point-blank range, pretty much. Although the gravity, I think, would probably kill me quicker than the fire. Crush you, wouldn't it? That kind of range? What do I know? Let me in! I love how Spock just randomly appears when you're playing this single player. It's good, because if you'd got trapped with rubbish pathfinding...
Lieutenant, we have reached the station's core. We seek whatever further assistance you can provide.
The only way forward is to shut down the core's rings. To do this, you will need to work together. One of you must scan the control console to stop the ring. This will allow the other person to engage the locking mechanism.
What?
Commander, I must warn you, a manual shutdown under these circumstances is highly risky.
Gotcha.
Yeah, risky. He means he has to do it.
Okay. That's the locking mechanism. Spock can slow down the ring long enough, I can shoot it.
Right, left trigger to aim. Right trigger to fire.
Captain. Now would be a good time to shoot the locking mechanism.
It would. So he is doing the shutdown
thing. Success, Captain.
That's good.
We must repeat the maneuver for the remaining rings.
With the sun, like, right over there. It's right there. Oh, this is cool, though. In fact, gravity's just aimed at the floor. I can run around in full 360.
Split up if this is going to work.
There it is. Come on, Mr. Spock, do the shutdown thing.
Stop. That brake is exposed.
Yay! I didn't even have to tell him.
Just one more ring to go.
I didn't have to tell him to stop the movement. That was good. And the tricorder is actually useful. Oh, look at this. There it is. Whoa, no! Ah!
This is falling apart!
Oh, I should have known that was going to happen.
Perhaps a phaser blast would release the mechanism.
Oh, great. So, dealing with the...
Outward. Let's keep moving.
The ring problem and the sun problem at the same time. Aww. Combined problems? I'm not good at multitasking. Any more things for me to disable, though, is there? Come on, come on, come on, come on. Hey! At least you can do skipping. Run for cover. Let's go. I think I'm getting better at this already. It's supposed to like 20 minutes.
Through the core, let's find that stranded crew.
Okay, come on, Spock. Come on, Spock. Let's do this! Get your skinny blue butt through there. Oh. More sun things.
Great, no cover. I believe we may be able to open those vents. Perhaps our phasers will work. Worth a shot.
Shoot the blue vents.
It works! Keep shooting out those vents! Take cover.
I am in cover. Ouch. Okay, so apparently they don't last forever. And I have to shoot exactly on it to make it pop up. Right, I thought I was getting better. I opened my mouth too soon. Still suck at games like this. I might still enjoy it. Why are we running towards the sun? Oh yeah, that's it. It's like an Elite Dangerous though when you pop out right from the sun, that panics the hell out of me.
This one is still alive.
And a woman.
Quick, let's get him inside.
Oh, it's a guy? Oh, it looks like a woman. Pretty sure that's a woman.
Life support is now at 4% and failing. Transporter is still unable to obtain a reliable signal.
Let me worry about the transporter. Just get your people ready to beam out. What are you waiting for?
I was speaking to my captain.
It's all right, Commander. Do as he says.
Aye, Captain.
Ah, Captain. I don't believe we've met. I'm James Kirk, Captain of the USS Enterprise. And you are?
I am in need of assistance, Captain.
T'Mon?
Mr. Spock, it is a relief to see you here.
Oh, T'Mon, typical.
In what way can we assist you?
Spock gets in
our
first.
Our station has experienced a complete loss of power. Our transporter functions are also unreliable. There does not appear to be a safe way to beam out.
There's always a way. Scotty, think you can get a lock on me?
I'll try, sir. What's going on down there, Captain?
That was a wake-up call, Mr. Scott. I need you to work a little faster.
On it, sir.
We should make our way to the transporter, Captain.
After you. So, how do you two know each other?
We were classmates back on Vulcan.
Just classmates?
I realize this may be difficult for you to understand, Captain, but on Vulcan, relationships between the sexes do not automatically imply an intimate past.
Another reason I'm glad I'm not a Vulcan.
New research data on the Helios control cluster. What do I get? Access point granting engineers access to Helios station control systems. Decentralized command and control allows for rapid response to emergencies regardless of engineer location, which is another way of saying the engineers never have an excuse for not addressing a problem. It smells to me like a trap set by blame-obsessed bureaucrats sitting behind a desk somewhere who never have to take responsibility for anything. But I may be biased. I missed one! Oh, as always! There's me. I've been scanning everything that I can during non-action sequences. And I missed one. Great. Hi.
I've got manual lock, Captain. Ready and waiting for transport.
See? There's always a way. After you, Captain.
I will not leave this vessel until my crew is safely out of danger. As a captain yourself, I'm sure you would do the same.
I like this one.
There are a few that you do not like, Captain.
True. True story.
Prepare to energize.
Thank you.
Okay, she says thank you and then they all die.
The station's not going to hold.
to the shuttle. Run!
I've got to run, but I go the wrong way and die. Like that. Yeah. It's like Sam's going to run and then the camera shoots up to the sky for no reason. That was fun. Let's try that again. And this time not have the camera glitch, please.
We gotta get back to the shuttle. Run!
Okay. I'm running.
Keep moving!
I've got to try and predict where the explosions
are. I do not think this station is salvageable, Captain.
Oh, you think so?
Okay, I'm running.
There is no time to stop.
Oh, really? But I want to scan things!
No time to watch the sunset. Run!
Oh, that's going to be pretty. There, look, I can watch it. But all those other people died. I mean, come on. That was a bit of a rubbish rescue mission. But hey, the theme they designed for this is as epic as it needs to be. Thanks for watching this first part. If you enjoyed it, comment, like, and subscribe. I'll see you guys next time.